I think if we have coercive control laws, if the police could question and ask, is he tracking your phone? Is he controlling what you wear? Is he controlling the finances? If we can have a checklist and the police can say, well, yes, I think this is coercive control. And even if we could lock the perpetrators up for a couple of nights, take away their sense of entitlement, maybe this would just shake them up a bit.
Especially after a breach on a DVO. At the moment, a DVO is basically just a piece of paper, and these perpetrators aren't adhering to them and getting in contact, and that's where all the problem is starting.
It's 14 months since your daughter Hannah and your three grandchildren were murdered. What has been your focus since that horrendous act?
Coercive control, to get that message out there to the community so they can start looking at these red flags and know what to do and know how to support that person.
I'd like to see ads on TV showing what coercive control is. I would like to see a coercive control situation put into, say, Home and Away or Neighbours or one of the soap operas that adolescents like to watch. Because even today, so many young people don't understand what coercive control is. And I think if it's shown to them on a platform they understand, it could be very helpful.
And what else are you hoping your foundation, which is called Small Steps for Hannah, what are you hoping it will achieve beyond that too?
I'm involved with my friend Carolyn Robinson from Beyond DV, and we're now getting into schools and we're wanting to educate mother and daughters, and we also want to start with father and son education, just on what is a good relationship, a healthy relationship.
And then further down the track, you know, a 10-year scheme for us is hopefully we can start organising some gated communities for victims. So once they leave the perpetrators, they've got some sort of protection where it's harder for the perpetrator to get in. I know there is already some out there, but also just need so many more, especially the rural areas.